How many times have you heard, don't play in no man's land, or close the net, close the net? Now, if these are just barking orders yelled at you by your coach, then they could be very dangerous tips. And I'm going to explain exactly what I mean, especially the no man's land idea, as far as not to play in no man's land. Because if that's all you hear, then you're probably not practicing in no man's land, which can be very, very dangerous to your game. Because especially if you're a player that's 40, 50, 60, 70 years old out there playing, you're going to have to play in no man's land. That's how you get to the net. That's how you get in winning position. So just always being told to not play in no man's land, you think that every time you're in no man's land, it's a mistake to be there, and it's not. That's how you're going to get to be in the winning position. Now, to make it clear, what you don't want to do is to be back here in no man's land, which I do see people do, and they just get stuck. You don't want to get stuck in no man's land. You don't want to be hitting 5-6 volleys in here. But you do need to be very skillful in no man's land, especially if you want to keep moving up the ranks. The Bryan brothers have said many, many times that they put themselves in position to get easy volleys, that the closer they are to the net, that the easier the game is. And that's 100% true. But you know what the Bryan brothers also do? They practice a lot back here. Okay, so in our 7-day double specialty shot challenge, we're going to be doing lots of drills to we get really, really good in this area of the court. Okay, we want to be great right here. So we're coming, so we're getting this volley, we're not missing it. I can't tell you how many times I watch a 3-0, 3-5, 4-0 player and they never get to the net because they don't have any control. If they get any kind of volley, if they get any kind of volley here in no man's land, they either miss it or they dump it right to the net person who poaches and crushes their partner, which you definitely don't want to be doing. So you want to be very, very comfortable back here. Yes, in a match, you want to basically have a one and done philosophy to where you can make a shot in no man's land, get out, get into winning position. But in practice, you actually want to be staying in no man's land and get very comfortable with the ball coming high way back here and be able to control it, coming fast and at your belly, coming low and having to do a half volley, having to do all these skills so that you're very, very comfortable and you can hit a skillful shot that gets you into a winning position at the net and makes a very, very tough passing shot for your opponent. Now, to be able to do that, you have to have very, very good technique. You have to what I call picture perfect technique. So that's what we're going to be developing in our 7-day specialty shot challenge. So if you're not signed up yet, you should be signing up because we're already getting students who have just got the first day. We're starting August 3rd, but I already have the first day in there and people are already writing me saying that they're running the first play of the first day. And my buddy Charles says it wasn't even fair. Like, he used the play and they just torched their opponents. My friend Mark Davis said that he worked the chip return, it worked to perfection, won the match. So it's already working, but we've got 21 drills to go. Another thing that we're going to do is we're gonna get skillful close to the net. Here's another tip that a lot of coaches will tell you is close the net, close the net, close the net. How many times have you heard that? Close the net. And so what happens? What do? You keep hearing close the net, so you keep coming in and coming in and get as close to the net as you can so your coach will be proud of you. And then what happens in the match? You get lobbed. Okay, so that's another tip. You know, don't play in no man's land. Close the net. These are dangerous tips if they're not explained. Yes, you want to get as close to the net as possible. If I see a floating volley, I want to get as close to the net as possible and end the point. Okay? But what happens if I go to close the net and as I'm hitting it, and you kind of know this, or you should know this, the better of a player you become, you kind of know when you're about to put the ball away and it's probably not coming back, or to where you're getting to the ball and it's a little tougher volley than you anticipated, or all of a sudden they're set up in a really good defensive formation and you're probably not going to put the ball away. Well, as you're closing the net and you feel like, well, this is just a little too low, I'm probably not going to put it away, then you got to pitch it and get back so that you can cover another volley and the lob. You want to get into a position to where you can close on a volley, okay, and you can get back for a lob. That's where you ideally want to play. But you do want to hit as many volleys as you can close to the net, okay? So in order to do this, you're going to have to do what? You're going to have to increase your reflexes. If you want to hit volleys around the net, which the Bryan brothers suggest, which a lot of players suggest, if you want to hit volleys around here, then your speed of hand is going to have to get better. Your touch and feel so you can hit angles is going to have to get better. And you're going to have to simplify. I know it sounds, it should be easy, but simplifying is the toughest thing for most people to do, myself included. If I'm out of practice, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be overreacting. That's the biggest killer of hitting volleys around the net, is people overreact. They make too big a move, and then they're volleying late, and that ball is going to fly on you. Or you know you're late, so then you flick over your wrist. But if you can learn how to get a nice, simple movement, and you just can't watch a video, guys, and go, oh, simple movement, got it. No, you got to practice it. That's why we're doing the 7-day specialty shot challenge, to where we're practicing all kinds of drills with the ball coming fast at us. So if you do have a ball machine, it's great. You're going to love the 7-day challenge. You can also just use your basket of balls. But what we practice is simplifying our move, so when the ball comes fast, we're there, we're on it. We're on it like that. And here's another cool thing about the 7-day specialty shot challenge. Yes, I am pitching it today because I want you to sign up. If you are able to complete the drills, if you're like, okay, Pete said in this area I should be 7 out of 10, and you video yourself and send it in, which we have an app where all you have to do is just click a button on your phone. Just click a big red button that's set up right there for you. Believe me, you don't have to be a tech whiz to do this. You just click the button, you film yourself, and it automatically will send to me. If you do that and you complete a challenge, you're going to get a doubles masters medal. Whoever gets the most doubles masters medals is going to train with me 2 days for free. That's just how passionate I am about our courses, about our students, about really connecting with you guys. My goal is to be the number one personalized online instructor on the planet. So the more I get to interact with you guys, by the way, in the 7-day challenge, you also can send me videos all week. You can ask me questions about doubles, your most burning doubles questions, and I will answer them. So it's a done with you process. It's just not, here are the videos, go get them, Tiger, although you can. I know lots of people actually like that. So if you just like to get the instruction and you don't want to be bothered or anything like that, you just kind of like to do it on your own, you can do it by yourself. But if you want to do it with me, that's the beauty of our challenges. So remember that, guys. We're going to be working on playing a lot in no man's land, practicing a lot in no man's land. So when we get our one or two volleys, you want to hit one, two volleys max in no man's land. Yes, we do want to get out of no man's land, but you've got to be great in there so you can get into the winning position. And you also have to simplify right here around the net, so that when you're right here around the net, you're not overreacting and missing volleys that you know that you should be putting away for yourself and your partner. All right, so we'll see ya. You can sign, if you're on YouTube right now, you can go in the description to sign up. And if you're on the webpage, you just look under this video and you click the button and get into our challenge. We're gonna be starting August 3rd. But if you wanna start practicing right now, day one video is right there for you. All right, so we'll see you on the next video. Hey guys, Pete with Crunch Time Coaching. Welcome to the 7-day doubles specialty shot challenge. I am really excited for this one because every day we're gonna have a different challenge and you can win a doubles masters medal. That's right, so we're gonna be doing 21 different drills. Might even add a couple bonus drills in there because yesterday somebody gave me a great drill to add. Don, thank you for that. And if you put yourself on video, now here's the thing, you can either send it through this video ask, or if you need longer time, you can actually make a YouTube link and still use the video ask, to where you basically respond by text, you put the YouTube link in the video ask, and then I will be able to see if you completed the challenge successfully. If you did, you win a doubles masters medal that I will send to you, okay? Now, whoever ends up with the most doubles masters medal, I might cry because this gift is so good. I thought, what would be the greatest gift and the most fun gift we could probably both have if you were the winner of this prestigious award? How about 2 days training with me one-on-one in Atlanta for 5 hours, okay? So we'll do 2.5 hours a day, right? That's 2.5 hours a day. And we will get out on the court. All you gotta take care of is travel and accommodations, and I'll be training you for 2 days. This is a $700 gift, basically. I'll also take you out to lunch. We'll be having a great time. So that's whoever gets the most medals, and we'll do it at your time, at your convenience, okay? So whenever you're comfortable to travel, you come train with me if you win this. All right, now today what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be working on our chip return. I think that if you really wanna be a doubles master, you gotta have a great chip return, because it could do so many things. Whether they're serving and volleying or staying back, it is just as effective. So I wanna set up the first play for us here. The first play is this. We got our server over there, we got our partner on the service line, and we got the net person in front of us. So the first play that we're gonna practice together is actually hitting a short chip. What we wanna do by hitting this short cross-court chip is draw our opponent forward so that they are forced to either go up the line, which basically leaves this wide open, or go cross court or lob. They're having to dig it out and they're off the court, which is gonna leave a big open gap right here. This is such a great play. I think everybody should master this. And even if you're playing somebody who serves and volleys, still getting it that low and going off the court is gonna give you and your partner a lot of opportunity. Then the next ball is gonna go right there. So to do this technique, first of all, we need to be in our continental grip. So you're basically in your shake hands grip. And what you have to get really, really good at, and this is where you might wanna take some notes, because people do this wrong. I do not want to see you come with a shoulder turn as you get ready to do this. What I want is you see the ball and you get your hands, you just relax your wrist and put those hands out in front, and then it's the pace of your running. You make this shot with your legs and not your hands. Your hands basically just stay still and you let the momentum of your legs make this shot. You can add a little bit of cut, and you also want to have your strings finish at your target. So I'm gonna demo a couple and I'm gonna set the challenge, and this will be your first drill, okay? By the way, every skill that I'm gonna show you, you can either use with your basket, your trusty basket of balls, or if you want to use a ball machine, you can also use a ball machine. I'll show you how to do it on both. So this is probably one of my favorite shots to teach students, and it's one of my favorite shots to use in doubles to this day. Even at a 5-0 level, especially if you're playing somebody with a kick serve, this is a great shot you can use. So I'm here and I wanna get set, and what I wanna practice, I wanna lead myself out in front and I wanna run through it. And you see, what I wanna do is you see the cone over there, and I wanna hit it basically to the right side of that cone.